welcome to a long-awaited return to YouTube for me. This is a bit different to my normal style of videos, which were predominantly gaming and whispered. Today I thought I was going to do a video showing off my shoe collection, because I'm a bit of a sneakerhead, although in England we do call them trainers, not sneakers. And today I'm going to be doing soft-spoken, maybe a bit of whispering thrown in there as well, and some tapping on the shoes. Hope you don't mind the view for this video. Not fully comfortable showing my face yet. Maybe we'll get there in the future. Maybe not. So, the first pair of shoes that we're going to show off are the Adidas TFL Continentals. These are the white Jubilee and Piccadilly colourway. This one here is the Piccadilly. So you can see it's got the blue Piccadilly logo there. It's got silver stripes on this side, blue stripes on this side. I've got the other shoe here, which has the silver Jubilee line on it. Again, with the blue stripes on the side and the silver stripe on this side. These shoes picked up, I believe, the day they dropped. I believe it was either last December or last November. Very, very nice shoe. Comfortable. Go with pretty much anything. That's why I quite like the Adidas Continental lineup, which you'll see in the next shoes coming up. I've got quite a few pairs. Obviously, these are worn quite a lot, but they're the type of shoe. Adidas Continentals, I see the same with Reebok Classics as well. They're the type of shoe where when you wear them in and they start to get those scuff marks, it sort of improves the look. Like a vintage wine, if you get what I mean. So yeah, they got the, also as well, I don't know if you can see that, they got a blue little toggle here on one of the laces, and then the other one is silver. So yeah, that's the first pair of shoes. The Adidas TFL Continentals Jubilee and Piccadilly. So the next pair of shoes we've got is another pair of Adidas Continentals. They are the Adidas Love Unites Pride Continentals. As you can see, they've got the rainbow flag here, and they've got the rainbow logo here on the tongue. They've also got, I don't know if it's, you can see that, but it says Love Unites on the inside. I picked these up, so funny story about these. I didn't know they existed. I mean, for a sneakerhead and to not know these existed is terrible, but I went down to Brighton in the south of England, which, if you know about gay culture in England, Brighton is quite an important place. I'd consider it the gay capital of the UK, really. But yeah, I went down there and I saw these in a shoe shop, and I was like, is that a Brighton exclusive? I have no idea. Went home, googled them, because they didn't have them in my size. Obviously, they'd be sold out in a... I'm quite a popular size. I'm either a 9 or a 9.5. Normally, in Adidas shoes, 9.5. Obviously, they'd be sold out in my size, because it's quite a popular size for men. And it was in Brighton, and everyone would be picking up these shoes. So I went home, ordered them, and just like the TFLs... I mean, I actually say these are a bit more comfortable than the TFLs. They're made out of a slightly more cushioned material on the inside. And the outside of these, what I love about Continentals as well is that they're mostly leather, so if you ever get any scuff marks on them, you can just get a wet wipe or wet bit of kitchen towel or anything and just wipe it off. So yeah, love these shoes. Again, you can wear them with pretty much anything. I tend to have a rolled up jeans, either black or blue, and you can just pair them with that. So the next pair we've got is actually a pair that I don't wear too often. It's another pair of Adidas Continentals. We have got the Donald Glover Continentals. So maybe 5 or 6 months ago, Donald Glover, or Childish Gambino, depending on how you know him, did a collaboration with Adidas, and he made a few pair of shoes. I believe he did a pair of Nizzos. I think they're called Nizzos. He did Continentals, and then I can't remember what the other pair he did was. But yeah, I picked up the Continentals because I'm a big fan of Continentals. They're a bit of a strange style. They're like knitted. I don't really know how to describe it. The laces, I don't know if you can see, but they like pull apart quite easily, kind of like stitched together. It's a very nice style, but they're not as comfortable as the other two pairs. I'd wear them more often if I didn't have already two pairs of Continentals I absolutely love, but they're a nice pair of shoes to have in the collection. Always find myself really picking up special shoes like this, like special collaborations, as you saw with the TFL and the Pride shoes. But yeah, not much to say about these. They're creamy colour. I don't know if it comes off in the video because it's quite bright in the room that I'm in, but they're a sort of creamy colour, so they offer a different sort of colourway to the other two pairs. But again, not really worn them that much, so maybe I should in the future. So the next pair of shoes we have is probably my favourite of the bunch. These are the Adidas NMDR1 triple white prime knits. So I picked these up in 2017 and I still have them to this day. They are obviously not as white as they used to be, because I mean, I've been wearing them for 2 years straight. When I first got them, they were very bright white, very shiny. But now they're really worn down, got loads of marks on them, starting to wear away around the toe line, as most shoes do really. But I was big into NMDs back in 2017, and these were my favourite pair. They're just really stylish, I think, and you can wear them with jeans, with tracksuit, with anything really, with shorts. I've been wearing these every summer since 2017, just because they go so well with shorts and a nice pair of ankle socks, or maybe no socks at all. But yeah, NMD is so comfortable. If you're looking for entry into Adidas shoes, or just running shoes maybe, or you want to get into collecting trainers, NMDs, there's so many different variants, so many different colorways, and I promise you they're all so comfortable. So yeah, that's the Adidas NMDR1 Prime Knit Triple Whites. My favorite pair of shoes. These are the version, I believe, the text is all rubbed off there anyway. Let me check the other shoe, see if I've got text on there. So there is normally text on this part of the shoe here. This is the English variant. There is a variant with Japanese text, but I did not get them because they were not out at the time I bought these shoes. So, yep, moving on to the next pair now. So, as I said with the last shoe, I was really into NMDs back in 2017. And this is actually the first pair of NMDs that I picked up. They are the NMDR1s in blue, which, again, are very, very stylish and very comfortable. These are starting to wear away massively now. The bit on the back here, this rubber bit, is starting to peel off on the other shoe. I barely ever wear these anymore. If I wear them, it's when I'm probably going to the gym or going for a run. So yeah, not much to say about these apart from that they're extremely comfortable, and they are really the shoe that got me into collecting in the first place. Next, we have got two pairs of the same shoe in different colours. This one is the Adidas Derupt in a core black and bluebird. So Derupt shoes are Adidas's shoes with the mesh on the outside, if you can see. So it's like a layer of material, and then over the top we've got the mesh, which goes down all the way onto the sole here. So these Adidas were doing a 50% off warehouse sale maybe earlier this year, and I worked out that instead of getting one pair of more expensive shoes, I could get two pairs of Derupts in different colours for the same price. So these are the black and blue ones. I wear these mainly with black Adidas tracksuit bottoms. They go really well with them. A really comfortable shoe. Offer great heel support as well, which is very nice. Just if you're doing loads of walking. Again, these can be used for running shoes, although I wouldn't wear them simply because NMDs are better for that, better for the gym as well. But yeah, that's the black and blue ones. And then with them, I also got these ones in white and red. What I like about these is that they're white and red, but then they've got the black laces and mesh along the bottom here. Really contrasts well. Black and red, I feel, is a good colour contrast, as well as black and white. So it's just a very stylish shoe all around. I was wearing these in the summer with shorts on sunny days, because white shoes on a sunny day, really, what can you beat? What beats that? Not much, in my opinion. So, the next shoe we have is another pair of NMDs, but these are XR1s in the black and grey and white striped variant. So these are slightly different to the R1s, because the R1s are one large body of material, like the whole thing included, but these are the body of material, but then they've got these rubber bits on the side that hold in the laces. So I don't know if you can see that, you can like separate them. So yeah, they're really, really comfortable. They've also got a slightly different pulley material, pulley method on the back. So I really enjoy having hooks on the back of my shoes, because it helps putting them on. This one is slightly different, you can pull it there and back. But yeah, the XR1s, pretty similar to the R1s in terms of comfort. Just obviously a different style, really, so it depends what you like about them. But these, again, mainly go with tracksuit. Wouldn't really wear these with jeans, but I'd have to depend on my mood. But there's not much else to say about them. Next pair here is something a bit extravagant. Bought these on a bit of a whim, and I've worn them a couple of times, but they're the sort of shoe that you're so worried about getting them dirty that you never want to wear them. They are the Adidas NMD CS1s with the koi fish art on them. So as you can see, there's a big black swirl around here, and these are quite a high top as well. And then on the side, you've got the half semicircle here with the koi fish art. So these are a very, very stylish pair of shoe. They're like a mid to, I think it's Adidas's sort of take on a mid to high fashion. Like, you might see a pair of like Balenciagas that look similar to this in a sort of shape, because Balenciagas have a model where it's sort of like a quite high top, all-in-one sock sort of shoe. But Adidas have done it here with the very stylish, I think it's sort of like Japanese inspired, I guess. But as I said, I've hardly ever worn them, and I've had them for about a year, simply because I don't want to get them dirty. And living in England, you never know when the sun's going to turn into rain, and you're going to be out in your white shoes in the rain and the mud. So it's quite risky to wear them. I'd wear them to maybe a party or an event where I know the risk is low to get them dirty, and I can look fashionable in them with a tight pair of maybe black skinny jeans. But yeah, overall, lovely, lovely shoe. Good to have in the collection, but wouldn't wear them most days. So I've got two more pairs of shoes left. I have loads more actually left, but I didn't want to make this video too long, particularly because it would take a while to render and upload. But if you want to see a part two to this video, please let me know in the comments. I appreciate, maybe there won't be that many people viewing, because I've been gone for a very, very long time. But yeah, if you do want to see part two, let me know in the comments. Leave a like on the video, subscribe if you're looking forward to that as well. So the first pair that we actually have here are the New Balance 373s in black with the grey logo here. I bought these maybe December 2017, looking for a pair of basically just casual shoes that I can wear with most outfits, and these done really well. What I like about them is that in certain lights as well, this bit on the back is sort of luminous, that it looks a bit pink, a bit silvery, shiny. And you can also just wear them, as I said, with pretty much anything. Black jeans, tracksuit bottoms, very stylish, and anyone that buys New Balance knows that they're very comfortable. If any Americans are watching, they might be thinking, oh, why is he preaching fashion about the shoes that my dad wears? But New Balance here in the UK is fashionable, what can I tell you? I mean, different shoes for different countries, I guess. But yeah, and I quite like New Balance. They make quite a few trendy shoes, but these are like the basic ones. Like, this is like New Balance's version of the Vans Old Schools, which I do not own a pair of, by the way, because I just can't stand them, really. I'm not a big fan. I do like Vans, but I'm not a big fan of the Old Schools, because I'm the sort of person that doesn't want to wear a pair of shoes that everyone else owns. apart from these, maybe just because I needed a pair of just basic shoes. And then the last pair of shoes is another pair of New Balance. They are the 90s style of Life white, laser and blue. White and laser blue even, sorry. These are a bit obviously more extravagant than the last pair of New Balance I showed. But I saw these. They were on a website for about 30 quid. And I was like, pair of shoes that nice for 30 quid. Have to pick them up. So they got the white inside here. They got the blue and white and pink tongue. And then all around it's just blue, white and pink with the white New Balance logo. They're a bit more chunky than the last pair of New Balance that I showed, but these go really well with like a tight pair of material, a tight pair of like sweatpants variants of tracksuit bottoms, like not the like nylon sports ones, just like a really, I don't really know the correct description of them, but like the ones that are more comfort sweatpants style, a tight pair of those that go around the ankle and then make the shoe look bigger. I think if you're going to wear a chunky shoe like this, tight trousers are essential because they really accentuate the shoe. I would not wear these with a pair of skater jeans, for example, because the contrast between them would look odd to me, at least. So yeah, I really like this pair of shoes, and 30 quid, what a bargain. That's if any of you are sneakerheads out there and you do live in the UK, I'd recommend following Sneaker Deals GB on Twitter and Instagram. Always posting really, really good deals. Always post deals not only on Adidas and New Balance, which as you could have seen there, I pretty much only own Adidas and New Balance, but he's posting deals on Air Maxes, Jordans, even stuff like Clark's shoes as well, if you're looking for a smart pair of shoes to wear to a wedding, to your work. But yeah, so follow them. Also follow me on Twitter. My at is ASMRGamingUK. Obviously, this wasn't a gaming video, but really wanted to bring something different to the table for my comeback to YouTube. Hopefully, the audio's okay. I'm recording on a different microphone. I do have the Blue Yeti, full-size one, but I'm recording on a Blue Yeti Nano at the moment, which I picked up a few months ago because I saw a great deal on it. And I thought it would be interesting just to see if it was comparable to the Blue Yeti in any way. And I've used it a few times for Discord calls and it seems alright. So hopefully the audio settings and the video quality are good enough for this. But yeah, thanks for everything, guys. Maybe I'll be back with some more videos in the future. Hopefully at least. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't